in CHC is a special collection that houses materials from people from Cuba and the diaspora. We are curators of people's stories. Well, the Cuban Heritage Collection started was born out of the vision of Cuban librarians who immigrated to the United States and wanted to preserve the history of their country, the history of the exile experience here in Miami. So when they came here, they realized that there was a history taking place and that they needed to start collecting. The importance of the collection is that it documents the history of the Cuban people, and that's important. And it's important because it was a turning point in U.S. history and world history to have this migration experience in the United States. It was tied to the Cold War, and those moments have historical impacts that go beyond Cuba in the United States. We try to collect papers that have historical significance, for instance. But we also collect pictures of regular people, so we're not just collecting the history of famous people, but of ordinary people as well. Every time you open a box, it's somebody's story. So what's inside the vault, as we call it? We have rare books, archival collections, rare manuscripts from colonial times to the present. Maps, rare maps of Cuba, in the different ways they were represented. Rare book by Bartolomé de las Casas, you know, that talks about the Native Americans' plight in the New World. Publications from people in Guantanamo Bay, again, a group of refugees, and they published their own newspaper. So that's in the CHC. A lot of plays, so that's one of the specialties of CHC, that we collect the papers of playwrights. You have those illustrations. You have the papers of organizations such as schools in Cuba, like the Medici Academy or the Rustin Academy, whose members have deposited their records here in CHC because they want them to be preserved. Photographs of people being processed at the Cuban Refugee Center. You would see newsletters published by the Cuban Refugee Center on ESL classes. Notebooks and small work of art produced by the anthropologist Lydia Cabrera, who was an anthropologist. I liked her her decoration of the Virgin. We also have a collection of natural history of Cuba that includes these rare shells that you can only find in Cuba. You would see Celia Cruz's shoes also, so we have objects. Letters that people are writing to each other about what is happening in their lives, in their diaries. You would see photographs of regular people that lived in Cuba and they wanted to be safe. Librarians have a long view of history. We don't think of tomorrow, we think 100, 200 years from now, people are going to want to study Cuba, the Caribbean, and they're going to want to look at resources, at texts, at stories about these places. Collections and libraries always have relevance. It's what you choose to do with them. So if you want to study the history of Cuba and the diaspora, you come here because that is the scope of the collection.